Hi friends, welcome to Florence Programming. In this video, I am going to explain you about static keyword in Java programming. Static keyword can be used with class, variable, method and block. Once you define a field or method as a static, it is common for every object in a particular class. And this belongs to the class, not belongs to an object. In Java, if you define a field as static, then the field can be used as a common property for all instances. So it will maintain only one value for the field. If you are creating some 100 objects, all the objects will maintain only one value for particular field. So the value of this static field will be shared across all objects of either same of any different classes. In the memory perspective of static variables, it will be stored in metaspace, which will be available in JVM memory. So it is not stored in a common memory locations like other variables. It will be stored in a metaspace. And in static methods, we cannot use this and super keyword. Why? Because this will represent the current object. But a static will not support for objects. That is why this operator will not support for static. Similarly, super keyword. Super keyword we will use with inheritance to refer the parent classes. So again, the super will represent the immediate parent class. So here we cannot use the super keyword with static method. And if you define a field as a final static, then it will be considered as constant. We can define static like this. This is one example class, the class name simple static example. And this is the method I have defined, static void method name. So static is the keyword. Main method. So once you, my method. Once you define a method as a static, that method can be accessed without object. We can access the method like this, or we can access the method through its classes. Now we can see some example how to use static field and static methods. I will explain these through some examples. Just we can define, this is our IDE we are using throughout the videos. We can create a class file. So the name of the class, just I am giving static one. This is the name of the class I am giving. So the class has been created here. Now we can start, we can define our static example, static underscore example. This is the class name you are defining here. First, I will explain you static method. So static void method name, this time I'm giving display. It's okay. So here inside system.out.println, we can display some message, static method. It's okay. We have created. Now we can define our main method, public static void main string. So here we can call the method. So just I will try to create an object. This is the way we will do all the program. So similarly, I am creating object here. S1 is equal to new static example. This is our class. What we have created here, we have created object. The name of the object is S1. This is the usual way we will call the method. So this time only display. Since display is a static method and we are calling this as through object. So just it is giving warning that you are supposed to call the method. See, the static method display from static should be accessed in static way. So some warning we are getting here. So just we can run the program. It will display static method. But we are not able to complete the program without this warning. So just I am giving here only display. So only display it is not recognized. We have to add either class or object. So just we are using a class static underscore example dot display. So now our program will not have any warning or nothing. So just it will explain. It will run the code. See, just save the program and we can the values. So static method, it is common for all the objects. So it will maintain only one value for every object. So when we can use static method, or what is the purpose of using static method? Suppose you want to develop applications which is independent of any instance. So such cases we can use static method. Or otherwise, suppose you want to maintain a common value or single value for all the objects. So such a time that value can be stored in a variable which is declared as static. So whenever you want to make a common entry for all the objects, so such cases we can use the static method objects. Now I will explain static field, how to define static field. I am creating one static, that is static int. A is a variable field name. So here I am using static int A. So just I am displaying A here. So we can run the program. So the output test, we got it. Now let me see what will happen when you create multiple objects and how the values is getting changed. See here two objects. Now I am creating, let me create one constructor here, static underscore example. This is a default constructor. So A value I am defining here 10. Yes. And next, I am defining parameterized constructor. One more constructor. Let me see the difference, how we are accessing the static index. And we can assign the value of x here. Yes, we have created. Now, here two objects we have created. One we can call the object with the default constructor, and another one we can call the object by passing some value. So here I am calling this method. So just this method I am defining just like values, displaying the value of x. Now let me try. Yes, one dot display and yes, two dot display. Let me see what is the output we are getting here, because yes, one we are calling with the default argument, so it will be 10, and yes, two we are calling with 12, so it will go with the parameterized constructor. So the value of 12 will be assigned here. Now we are calling s1.display and s2.display. Let me see what will be the output for this program. Somewhere some error. Let me see where it is. Main method. Unresolved compilation problem. Static 1.main. Why? One more. Right. It will be incomplete. Yes. Now we can run the program. See, the output we got only 12 for this S1 object, and even for S2 object also we got 12. How? This is the power of static. See, S2 we are creating and with the value 12. So the value, since A is a static object, it will maintain only one value for entire object. So which one is the latest value for A? 12 is the latest value for A. So this 12 will be assigned to A, and this A is common for all the object. If you are creating 100 object, for all 100 object this A is common. So even here S1 we are creating with the default constructor, so in the S1 the value will be 10, and again S2 we are creating with parameterized constructor, we are passing some other value that will be assigned. So this is the final value for the variable A. So that is why for S1 and S2 it is the output, it is giving us 12. So this is the use of static. So static will maintain only one value for the variable for all objects. So whenever we are going for application which is independent of static, or which is independent of instances, we can go with static variable. Hope you understood about static keyword in Java programming. Thank you for watching.